Hey everyone, welcome to a new episode of Dev with Serdar. And in this episode, I'm going to walk you through the process of getting set up with Python in Microsoft Windows in 2023. So the first thing you'll want to do when you're setting up Python in Windows is choose the right version of Python. Now for this video, I'm going to be showing you how to work with the stock version of Python, the one that's available from python.org, the most commonly used version, also known as CPython. Other Python distributions do exist. There's Anaconda, there's WinPython, but it's best to get your legs, so to speak, with the stock version of Python first. And those other distributions are going to be worth talking about in their own videos. Now, generally, if you go to python.org and click the download button, like this, you will get an installation package for Windows that you can simply run and use. Now, if you drill down into the site a little bit, you'll notice that there will be a number of different download options available for Windows. But the one you generally most want to use is the 64-bit MSI installer package. These other versions are for more specialized use, or they are for other platforms entirely. Now, you might also at some point have stumbled across the Microsoft Store version of Python. For instance, let's say you typed Python in a command line and you got redirected to the Microsoft Store. Now, generally, it's best just to use the python.org version. I found that the Microsoft Store version can be quirky in ways that make things difficult in the long run. Another quick note for people on earlier versions of Windows. If you are stuck running Windows 7 for whatever reason, please note that the newest version of Python you will be able to use in Windows 7 is Python 3.8. And both Windows 7 and Python 3.8 are no longer supported. So if it is at all possible for you to move to a newer version of Windows, do so, because you'll be on a newer version of Windows that's supported and a newer version of Python that's also supported. Now, once you have the install package, you will want to run it with admin privileges, especially if you don't run with an admin account as the default. You do this, and it will ensure that you can install the files wherever you want to, and it will prevent other permissions issues from popping up along the way. I happen to be running administrator on this system because I'm the only account on this system. Now, on the first screen for the installer, there's one option here that is absolutely essential. And that is this option, Add to Path. When you do this, the Python interpreter will automatically be added to the system path. And this way, tools like pip, which are invoked from the command line, will behave correctly, among other kinds of tools that require path to be present for the Python interpreter. So this is a must. Next, we're going to click Customize Installation, since there are some default settings that are worth modifying. So in the second screen, you can actually leave most of these options alone. If the Install PyLauncher selection isn't checked, however, enable it. This is really useful. The PyLauncher is a utility. It's activated from the command line by just typing py, P-Y, and it lets you work with multiple Python versions side by side. It also gives you diagnostics about your Python installs, so it's massively useful to have. Now, the only time you should not enable this option is if you're installing a beta version of Python that is of a higher revision number than the version you're already using. For instance, I already have 3.11 installed somewhere. If I installed the beta for 3.12, I would not check this option when installing that beta. What happens is the installer may not be able to complete if you do this because it thinks there's a version conflict problem and it will stop the install and roll everything back. But in this case, here we do want it. Now in the next pane, we're going to want to customize the location where Python is installed. I tend to put Python in a very high-level directory to make it convenient to find. And as you can see, the default installation directory is kind of buried. Now, wherever you choose to put Python, it should be a directory that you have write permissions for when you're running the installer. Again, I'm running as admin, so I can put this anywhere. And so my choice of directory is right off the root of my C drive. It makes it easy to find. Another thing I should note here is that you don't want to install Python on a removable drive. Python expects to be installed somewhere permanent. If you want a Python distribution that's designed to be portable, it's designed to run on removable drives, check out WinPython. And again, that's something we'll explore later. The other options in the screen here, by the way, can also be left alone. If you're doing any development in C with Python, though, such as using Cython, you want to check the options Download Debugging Symbols and Download Debug Binaries. But for day-to-day use, we don't need these. Now, once the setup process is complete, and I'm going to skip past the installation, you should be able to kick open a console and type py-0p to see all of the installed Python instances in your system. This is where the Py Launcher comes in handy, by the way. And this is one of the things that it can do for us. And what we see here is we have an entry with a star next to it. That's the one we just installed, and that's currently listed as our default Python instance. In this case, I also have a beta version in there, but we want 3.11 to be the default since it's the currently supported release version. So another nice reason that we want to use the Py Launcher, by the way, is so that we can manage multiple versions of Python side by side without conflicts. At one point, I had something like 6 versions of Python installed in this machine. That was before I cleaned up. But they were all running side by side independently without issues, thanks to the Py Launcher. Finally, if you want to remove an edition of Python that's been installed in this fashion, you go to the Apps pane in the Settings menu to do this in Windows. Now you'll notice here that we've got uninstallers for 3.11, the beta of 3.12, and a separate uninstaller for the Py Launcher, for the Py command line utility. This is really useful because this way you can remove that independently of anything else. So if I wanted to reinstall a higher beta version like Python 3.12, and I wanted to reinstall the Py Launcher to go with it, I could remove it here first and then reinstall it with the beta, and we wouldn't have that version conflict issue that I was talking about earlier. So there you have it, the basics of getting Python installed in Windows in 2023. And that's it for this episode. If you liked it, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and, of course, InfoWorld.com.